This tutorial is on dimensional analysis. We find that dimensional analysis is a method for calculation utilizing the knowledge of units. By so doing, we can use conversion factors, multiply or divide by a factor, and yield the units of the desired answer. These conversion factors can be used to manipulate the units. For example, the desired unit can be obtained by the given unit multiplied by some conversion factor. These conversion factors are simple ratios. For example, conversion between inches and centimeters. If I want to convert from centimeters to inches, I would say 1 inch divided by 2.54 centimeters. Or if I want to convert from inches to centimeters, I would say 2.54 centimeters divided by 1 inch. So that first one would convert centimeters to inches, and the second would be used to convert inches to centimeters. So steps to solving a dimensional analysis problem, you'll read the problem carefully and be sure you know what the question is asking. Then you want to tabulate all the data in the problem, including the proper units. That'll be important for your conversion. You want to determine which principles are involved in the problem, and you want to look for the unit relationships that are going to be needed to solve that unit conversion type problem. For example, our inches to centimeters conversion. Then you're going to set up the problem in a neat and organized fashion. You want to make sure that all the units that you don't want, including the units you are given, cancel, yielding only the units of the desired answer. Then you're going to proceed with the calculation, being sure that your answer has the correct number of significant figures and is followed by the proper unit. Then check and see if that answer is reasonable. That is, does the answer make sense? Don't be fooled by a calculator error giving you the wrong answer with the right setup. So let's look at 10.2 inches converted to centimeters. To do that, we're going to start with our unit relationship converting inches to centimeters. Remember, we said 1 inch is 2.54 centimeters. So if we take the 10.2 inches, we're going to use our unit relation that we're given. Note we're going to multiply by 2.54 centimeters divided by 1 inch. Note that the inches cancel. And then you're going to tabulate that response, and you should get 25.9 centimeters. Note that you have more centimeters than inches, so that answer seems reasonable. Now, if you want to convert 55 miles per hour to kilometers per second, we're going to have two different relationships, one for length and one for time. Now, when we want to convert miles per hour, for example, take the time unit first, 1 hour equals 3,600 seconds. Using that conversion would give us miles per second. And then we convert the length unit of miles to kilometers. So 1 mile is 1.609 kilometers. So if we start our calculation using 55 miles per hour, we do our time conversion first. So 1 hour goes on the top, 3,600 seconds goes on the bottom. The hours cancel, yielding miles per second as our unit. We tack on another conversion factor where we have multiplied 1.609 kilometers divided by 1 mile. Note the miles cancel and leave us with kilometers per second. So those are the right units. Calculate that with your calculator, and you find you get 0.025 kilometers per second as our answer. Since the time unit went way down and the length unit changed somewhat, but not a lot, the much smaller number does make sense. Now, if we consider 100 square inches to square meters, note that the length unit is squared, which would correspond to an area. Note the decimal after the 100, which is attempting to indicate three significant figures on the 100. So our methodology, we want to take the square inches to square meters And so we want to use the unit conversion of 1 meter equals 39.37 inches. So we start by realizing that inches squared is inches multiplied by inches, and meters squared is meters times meters. So the conversion would have to be done twice to work, and if it were cubed like a volume, you would have to cube the conversion factor as well. So if we start with 100 inches squared, we then would use our 39.37 inches on the bottom, 1 meter on the top. Notice one of the inches cancels, but not both. So I would need to do that conversion again, or square the total conversion factor. And this way you can see both of the inches cancel, and you see on the top meters times meters, which would yield meters squared. So we have the correct units. Run that through your calculator, and you will get 0.0645 meters squared. And so that concludes our tutorial on the elementary dimensional analysis used for unit conversions.